instead of backwards. Alright, facial bone. Am I okay? Did I miss a slide there? I'm okay?
I'm good.
Alright, so these are basically the bones that make up the facial portion, except for the frontal bone here. Everything else up front here is considered a facial bone. Alright? The first one is actually your nose. If you break your nose, okay? It's not the cartilage that you notice that's disappeared from the skull because it's all soft tissue. It's this bridge of your nose right here. So the bridge of your nose is the nasal bone right there. Okay? If you kind of reach in and you know, sometimes you're doing this and you got a headache and your eyes are hurting, you pinch in and you feel where you can actually feel the lacrimal ducts on each side. You can feel that, right? And you're picking all the little sleepy goobers out of there, right? What you're actually touching is the next bone over, which is deep inside the socket right here. This is the lacrimal bone. It's a really small little bone. Forms part of the socket, but the important part is it has these fossa in it through which the tear duct apparatus goes through. So remember we said, you remember, drains from out here and drains across the eye and then down the puncta into the nose. That's how it gets in there. It gets through this bone right here, right there. So the thing that happens here is if you break your nose, okay, you get whacked and you actually kind of crack this nose, if you also happen to crack or dislodge the lacrimal bone, you have tear problems. And you'll actually have tearing if you can't drain the duct properly, if you crack that bone and it interferes with the lacrimal duct system, you have problems outside of just having broken your bone. Okay? So that's the reason why I say it, because it happens so often that, you know, it shows up. People, you know, otherwise you wouldn't even worry about this bone. They wouldn't tell you about it because it's so small. But it's this guy right inside there. There's the lacrimal bone. Okay? The next one is the vomer bone. This is actually sort of sitting on the roof of your mouth, and it creates the lower portion of your nasal septum. Okay, so it divides right and left, but from the inferior aspect. So it's this little bone that kind of pops up right here. There's a little bony ridge to it. Okay, that's the vomer bone, to which then all the cartilage and everything else attaches. That's the vomer.